Late September, everything was peachy as Netball Australia announced that mining company Hancock Prospecting, chaired by billionaire Gina Rinehart, was signing on as a principal partner in a deal worth $15 million.
They know what's at stake now.
In the aftermath, there were whispers of consternation as players weren't exactly thrilled about wearing the logo of a fossil fuel polluter.
For anyone who's concerned about the environment, there's issues there. Netball Australia, there just needed to be some open dialogue around the means to everybody and is everybody okay with that.
But focus soon shifted as Indigenous Diamonds player Danelle Wallum voiced her concerns about wearing the Hancock logo. After learning about views expressed in 1984 in relation to First Nations people by the company's founder, Lang Hancock.
The ones that are no good to themselves, I would dope the water up so that they were sterile and would breed themselves out.
In game one of a recent series against New Zealand, the Hancock logo was not featured on the uniform.
What exactly has been going on behind the scenes?
There has been a lot going on. Obviously, we're great supporters of Hancock. We want to make this partnership work with them.
Yesterday, despite reports that Wallum and the Diamonds would wear the Hancock logo in next week's match against England, Hancock dramatically dropped this.
Hancock and Roy Hill do not wish to add to netball's disunity problems, and accordingly, Hancock has advised Netball Australia that it has withdrawn from its proposed partnership effective immediately.
For a sport currently around $11 million in the red, it's devastating.
We are reasonably concerned. It's very disappointing to lose this funding, which was really going to help accelerate us forward.
Taking a further swipe at Netball Australia, Hancock added,
Hancock and its executive chairman, Mrs. Rinehart, consider that it is unnecessary for sports organisations to be used as the vehicle for social or political causes. There are more targeted and genuine ways to progress social or political causes without virtue signalling or for self-publicity.
Well, obviously, Mrs. Rinehart's views are hers and we fully appreciate them.
The players issued a statement backing their Indigenous teammate, but the sport reels.
It just would have been their love and concern for their teammate. The Australian netball team have always been really, really aware of the fundamental role they play in terms of role models and ambassadors for the community, as well as that deep entrenched sisterhood and love for each other.
I think it all comes down to making sure there's a really strong balance. I think there is a really important role that sporting organisations do play to create a safe environment, to have really strong social conversations, but there's also needs to be a balance in terms of the commercial reality.
I feel so proud of them standing up for what they believe in, you know? And it feels like such an opportunity now for another sponsor to swoop in and look awesome, right?
Maybe like a Mike Cannon-Brooks Atlassian.
Yes, yes.
Given their stance when it comes to the environment, that would be a perfect fit.
Yeah.
Or alternatively, you know, Hamish, you're doing pretty well for yourself, you know? 15 mil, easy.
I was going to suggest the Parmesan cheese people. Rebrand thing going on. The thing that strikes me about this, it actually reminds me of the Sea Eagles and the Pride jerseys, a little bit of Essendon and the Andrew Thorburn case. In each of these circumstances, it seems like the club or the code hasn't quite done enough thinking about the culture within the organisation or the sport and had the conversations that might be necessary to make those things possible. So, you know, obviously the points made here, why didn't they have a conversation about perhaps discussing what had been said in the past and dealing with that up front so that players, you know, weren't put... I mean, you can understand how for an Indigenous player it would be very difficult to wear, you know, a logo, you know, like that.
Yeah.
Obviously, for the NRL team with the Pride jerseys, it was clear there was a bunch of people that were going to have problems putting that on. Mm. And it seems surprising that we get to this point before those conversations start to take place.
And also the idea that sport and politics and issues of social justice can be completely separated is really naive. You think back to the Australian teams that wouldn't tour South Africa during the apartheid era. Mm. You even think about things like Big Tobacco used to sponsor the NRL. It was called the Winfield Cup.
That's, you know, crazy. Sporting, that's crazy.
And it's
back in the good old days, Lisa.
Are we going to be saying that about sports bet? You know, I don't know.
Yeah.
Well, they're saying that betting agencies are a possible sponsor to step into the space.